Hey everyone, I'm going to show you how to do some animation using GreenSock or the GSAP library right inside a storyline to be able to expand something out and move some objects. Just a really simple example, but hopefully it shows you kind of a real world example of what you can do to create these like custom animations. So let's dive right into my project. And I have this like button, and I'm going to create a video in the future about the like button when you click on it on each page, how it can get tracked through XAPI. So make sure that you come back and check that out. But on that like button, when I click on it, and it's on the master slide, so I'm going to go into my master slide here. I want it to expand and give some room for you like this page, that text to pop up, and then have it kind of go back into its default state. So that's the goal. And I want to be able to animate certain objects over in order for it to give room. And there's really three different objects I need to animate. I need to animate, this is a group, but I need to expand out this rectangle. I need to move over this like button, and I need to move over the like text. And so that needs to move over, and I need to adjust the width. Now I'm going to use my tool that I've created, and you can check out that video at the end of the video. I'll link to the video about this tool just in general. But if you go to learningdojo.ninja/javascript-snippets, and then you just type in at the end of it, just type in GSAP, G-S-A-P, and then it'll go right to that tool. So this is the tool, learningdojo.ninja/javascript-snippets/GSAP. I'm going to use this tool in order to target and generate the code that I need to do exactly what I want to have this. I want the background to stretch out, and then I want the objects to move over. So let's go ahead and first of all, target that background. So in order to do that, I do have to preview this page and then use my inspect window to target this. So I'm going to just expand out that background first of all, because right now the text kind of shows up everything. And then that text should go away at the end of that timeline or at the end of the layer timeline. So let's go ahead and just do this one at a time. So I'm going to go into inspect, and then I'm going to click on this arrow in order to target. When I say target is we're finding that object and we're finding the model ID for that object. That way we can talk to it through our code. Clicking on that arrow allows me to then select this square. Now on that square, it's going to give me to the very bottom of that shape, but I need to have it actually be the storyline shape. It kind of groups it together. But all you do is scroll up until you see this slide object. Actually, no, this slide, not the maskable object, but the slide object and then vector shape right there. And then right next to it is the model ID. Now make sure you get this one and not the object group. The object group would be the full one, but we're just wanting to resize the shape itself. So I'm going to go ahead and just copy that ID and paste it over. Now when I paste it over on this website, now I need to just, let's remove the easing. This is from previous videos. So I'm going to remove the rotation. And I want to make sure that I remove all position. And what I want to do is do the scale X, which will basically stretch it out. So when I do the scale X, I'm just going to come in here to scale X and do a 2.4. So it's going to do 2 points. So it's going to be double the size plus 0.4. So let's go ahead and do that. Now I've already kind of tested this out. So I know that's the exact size that I want. So I'm going to go ahead and just leave it as is. Now, in order to really get the text position right, I need to kind of move this over a little bit. So I'm also going to do X percent, and this will basically move it over just kind of slightly. And I'm going to do it negative 10, a tenth of the width. And so X percent just takes a width of the object and animates it based on that. So I just want to move it over just kind of slightly. And that is the code I need right here. So I'm going to click on copy. And I'm going to go back into storyline into my master slide here. So I'm going to go into view and then slide master. And then I'm going to go into this main slide master. I'm going to have this happen when you click on that button. So let's go ahead and just click on that button. Click on add trigger. We're going to execute some JavaScript. But when the controls one is clicked right here, so I'm going to click OK. Now it's going to happen when you click on that, and I'm going to execute this JavaScript. So right there, let's go ahead and preview that. So I'm going to just close this out and preview this project real quick. And once I preview this project, I'm going to click on that like button and notice how it kind of stretches out. It gets double the width, double 2.4 basically is double plus a little bit more. and then it expands it out. Now I then need to move it back. So we are going to have to trigger this to come back at some point, but we also need to move over the like and the text like button. So, and I'm going to come back into my master slide. Well, actually let's preview that again in order to get the ID for that. We have our object automatically scaling. We're going to scale it back at some point, but let's go to the like button and let's get that. So I'm going to click on inspect for the next one. And I'm going to click on this arrow and go down to the like button. So this like icon. Now I will just move up a little bit until I get to the slide object vector shape right there. And there's the ID for that one. So I'm going to copy that one, paste it into this tool. And this one, I'm just going to move along X percent. I'm actually going to get rid of the scale and I'm just going to move this kind of over a little bit. Now I've already tested this out myself, but this is going to be 160. 100 is going to be the width of the actual object. So I'm going to do 160% in order to move it over. I've already tested that out, but again, you may want to play with it. If you want it to move to the left, you may have to do a negative. So keep that in mind. So I'm going to copy this code here. Now let's go back into our master slide here. And I'm going to on that object. So let's go back into slide master. And I'm going to go into this same execute JavaScript. And I'm going to modify this a little bit because it will bring in the default object one. But we're going to be talking to something else. And so what I want to do is add this as the like button. So you can name that whatever you want, but it just has to match right here on that second line. It just has to be different because you can't be animating the same object with different values. It's going to throw things off. So I'm going to click OK. Let's go ahead and close that out and preview it again. And it's just taking it one step at a time. Whenever you're working with these GSAP libraries, you're just basically targeting one thing, or I could move over the entire group if I wanted to, but I'm trying to make it individual so that slides over while the background expands. So I'm going to click on this, and you can see that's exactly what I want. But I want this text to go with it here. So I'm going to go ahead and grab that text next, and I should have stayed in preview. Got a little trigger happy, and I accidentally clicked close preview. I do that a lot, but I'm going to go into inspect. And I'm going to go ahead and click on this arrow again. And this time I'm going to target the text. Now the text is a little tricky because when I actually click on it, it doesn't hover over it. Let me go back here. I'm going to click on this arrow and then I'm going to move my cursor down. And this is really what I'm looking for right here. So you can find something right above it with text, but then you can move it down. And this is the data model ID that I want for that one. So I'm going to copy that and paste that over here. And this one, I want it to be very similar, but not as much. So I'm going to be 150 there. And that's really all I need to do there. So I'm going to click on copy and then come over and let's go ahead and paste that there. So actually I was in the slide master already. So let me go back into the slide master and we will call this one like text. So I'm going to say like text. So TXT. And then do the same thing like text right there. And there we go. Now, both of them should move over. The only problem is we need to then move it back. So let's go ahead and preview this real quick. And then we will add the code, which all we need to do is copy and paste the code that we have and then just change it back to its default values, basically. So let's come back in here, click on the like button. There we go. Both of them move over. That looks great. But now we need to trigger when this slide layer hides. We need to trigger that code. So let's go back into our master slide. And in the master slide, I'm going to click on execute JavaScript and I'm just going to copy all of that. Or I could just copy the trigger, either way works. Now I'm going to go into the liked page. And a lot of the times you have to kind of think, what is going to happen? What do I need or when do I want this to happen? And I want this to happen when the text kind of fades away. And right now it's set at 5 seconds. So what I can do, and I'm not really hiding the layer, I will need to hide the layer. So let me go ahead and hide this layer. And I'm gonna do this when the timeline ends. So I do want it to go away just so I can click on the layer again and have it show. But I'm gonna go ahead and say when the timeline ends, not starts. We'll do that when the timeline ends. And there we go. So it's gonna hide the layer first of all. But now I need to, when the timeline ends as well, I need to execute some JavaScript in order to bring that back. So I'm going to go back in here and click on execute JavaScript, and I'm going to paste the code that I had before. But now what I need to do is return it back to its normal state. So X percent, I'm just going to have to be zero here. So I'm going to go ahead and just type in zero there. And then the X scale X, and these don't even need to be in quotes. They can be in quotes, but that may change a little bit just so you know. But right here, the X percent, what I need to do is just change that back to zero. So I'm going to do that one as zero. I'm going to do this one as zero. And I'm going to do the scale X back to one, which is the 100%, which is its normal state. We scaled it a little bit, but we need to return it back to 100%. So with that in mind, we've now returned everything back. So let's go ahead and preview this. And I want to make sure that this happens before we hide the layer. Because what happens if you hide the layer, it doesn't run any other triggers after it. So you want to make sure that you hide the layer first or execute the JavaScript first and then hide the layer. So let's go ahead and preview that now. So I'm going to click on preview. Then I'm going to click the like button. You can see it expands. And once that goes away, you should see it come back here. And there we go. And now because I hid the layer, I can always show it again. That way I can have this animate out, I can expand it, give it a little bit more room, add some layer content, have that layer content be whatever I want, hide the layer, and then have this animate back. So you have to target these individual objects, which is a little annoying, but once you have it, you can just copy and paste it when you want to return it and other things like that. So hopefully this gives you an example of like a real world application for some of these green sock animations and something just very simple that I wanted to show. If you want to check out more, you can head on over to my website at learningdojo.ninja. And here you can check out all previous blog posts. You can also download free templates in Articulate Storyline 360 and XAPI templates. You can also check out full courses, everything from A to Z in Articulate Storyline 360, Adobe Captivate, XAPI Fundamentals, Camtasia, Articulate Rise, Custom SCORM, and HTML5 video. And if you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click the like button, and subscribe to my channel, as well as hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows my channel to continue to grow, and allows me to continue to produce these videos for you so you can become the best learning developer you can be and really extend and expand these authoring tools. If you have any other comments or suggestions, make sure that you make a comment down below, and I check those every single week. That's all I have for today, so thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.